Hi, in the previous video I made a basic third-person controller in Godot, but the camera was fixed. This time I implement and use a controllable camera that doesn't clip through the environment, and I also have the playable towards where it's facing. I open up the previous project, and in the project settings I named the first two 3D physics layers to environment and player. In the main scene I select the CSG combiner and change its collision mask to a player. Next, I create a new scene called Controllable Camera and place it under the player folder. In the new scene, I add a new spatial node called Gimbal H, and under it, I add another one called Gimbal V. I'll be using these nodes to rotate the camera instead of rotating it directly, otherwise it would act weird because of how quaternions work. My code is heavily inspired by KidsCanCode and Johnny Rouddro's videos, and I'll link them in the description box below. Under the Gimbal V node, I add a clip camera, set it's currently enabled, and move it to 6 units in the Z-axis. Next, I assign the controllable scene a new script called controllable camera, and in it, I add a class name statement. To determine how much and how quickly the camera can rotate, I define a few export variables and set them to some nice defaults. Next, I get onRed references to the gimbal nodes and the camera, and define a few fields to hold the current state of the camera. In the ready method, I set the mouse mode to capture, and in the input method, I toggle this between capture and visible if the UI cancel action is just pressed. This way, the cursor won't escape the game window by default, but if I wanted to, I can just hit the escape key to set it free. Next, I check if I'm still capturing input and that the input event is a mouse motion event. I decrease the horizontal and vertical movement rotations by the relative X and Y values of the event, multiplied by the sensitivity value. I also make sure to clamp the vertical rotation value between min and max pitch values. Finally, in the physics process method, I linear interpolate the horizontal gimbal's Y rotation to the horizontal rotation value and the vertical gimbal's X rotation to the vertical rotation value, both with a step of rotate speed times delta. With the basic camera controls done, I go back to the player scene, remove the old camera, add a new spatial node called CamRoot and move it to 3 units in the Y axis, and I place the controllable camera under it. Next, I get an unread reference to the camera. Go to the debugger script and use this reference to print the vertical and horizontal rotations of the camera. When I run the game, I can now move the mouse around to rotate the camera, and even if I get close to the ground or the walls, it doesn't clip through them. However, the player does not move relative to the camera, so let's fix it. I already have the player's movement direction on a vector, so if I just get the camera's rotation on the y-axis, I can apply that to it. For that, I go back to the player script, add an export field to determine the camera flow speed, and a float field to hold the player's current movement rotation. Next, I go into the physics process method, linear interpolate the move-rot value to the radian version of our camera's horizontal rotation, with a step of cam follow speed times delta, and rotate the direction vector around the y-axis using that value. Next, I replace the movedir vector in the A tan 2 call with the negative X and Z components of the direction vector. Now, when I launch the game, the player will not only move relative to the camera, but it will also face in the correct direction. To implement the zoom function, I go into the project settings and add two actions called zoom in and zoom out, and assign them up and down mouse wheel buttons. Next, I go back to the controllable camera script and define four export variables, min and max distance, follow speed and zoom step. I also define a float field to hold the current distance. In the ready method, I get the local Z position of the camera and assign it to the distance variable. In the input method, I check if I am capturing input and the zoom in action is just pressed, and if so, I subtract zoom step from distance and clamp it between min and max distance values. I deduplicate this statement and replace the zoom in action with the zoom out action and add zoom step instead of subtracting it to implement the zoom out function. Finally, I go into the physics process method and linear interpolate the camera's local Z position to the distance value with a step of falloff speed times delta. I add the distance value to the debug text and relaunch the game. Now I can zoom in and out using the mouse wheel, and if I do it while the camera is standing between the player and the wall, it doesn't clip through. So that's it for this video. In the next one, I'll be adding mobile controls to control the player and the camera, so stay tuned. As always, you can find links to the example project in the description box below. Thanks for watching.